Today we're talking about the Pilot H2 by AIPER, and yes, I'm about to show you actual use in a pool that had a lot of debris on the ground, on the floor. It's great for floors, corners, and steps, as you can see in the video coming up real soon. But let's talk about all the features and what it looks like, because it's right over here. And we want to thank AIPER for providing this for our review. Look at this. This is essentially like a vacuum, because it is a vacuum. It looks like a proper vacuum that you would have around your house, but this is made to be fully submerged. When they say made to be fully submerged, it means that if you don't submerge it, the filter will not work properly, the suction will not work properly, the motor will not work properly. So it needs to be fully submerged, and that means all the way to here, all the way to this opening right here, needs to be submerged so that the suction works. It's got two different modes, a normal mode and a full blast suction, really, really high powerful suction. It works like a charm. The battery, and that's why I love it so much, it is completely wireless. You don't have any hose, tube, electrical cable coming out of this thing. It is super light, as you can see. It's a little wet because I just used it, and I'll show you obviously all the ins and outs and everything that it's been able to do in this pool. You've got one button, the power button. It will obviously turn it on, shut it off, but change the modes between normal and I call it hyper blast. It does have two different modes. Up here, you can use the really nice pad, and this is what I like to use it with because it's got those little bristles. Now, albeit those bristles are not extremely strong or extremely coarse, which is a good thing because it will not damage your pool lining if you have a lining. It won't damage things like that, like if you have a hot tub or things like that, right? You've got little rollers to make it really easy to just roll at the bottom of your pool. And the suction comes right here. That's the opening. If you don't want to use this, you can just take it off, just like that. And there we go. And then you've got the opening, just like this one here, that will provide also suction if you have, you know, bigger debris, things that you want to catch in a corner, things like that, right? I love the fact that, and you'll see it in the video, of course, I love the fact that this handle right here is removable. I can remove this handle and put it to the side, and then any pool pole, and say that a couple times in a row, pool pole will fit right here because it's a universal fitting, and then you have basically you're extending your vacuum cleaning power and your access. So that's what I was doing when I went into the deep end of the pool. I had the pole, long pole, I was able to reach obviously all the way down to, it depends on how tall your pole is, how long your pole is, right? It does give you feedback with the color. Right here, just next to the Pilot H2 logo right here, there's a color here that tells you the battery health and what mode you're in. I found it a little hard to read, especially in sunlight. I had to go into the shade to kind of figure out, oh, this is the mode that I'm in. I will be truly transparent. The normal mode is okay for very light just cleaning if you're doing just pool maintenance. If you've got some extra grime, extra dirt that you're needing to pick up, I would definitely recommend the hyper blast mode, the second mode, to really get rid of that dirt. And let me show you the filter, what it looks like, and how you change it. This is where the filter resides, and I'll show you exactly. You just twist and turn, and this is it right here. That filter, it's so simple to use because you open it up just like that, and everything, whether it's sand, leaves, what have you, whatever comes out of it, this this little thing will basically be super easy to clean. It just got used, and as you can see in the video, it got really dirty. It took me, with a hose, maybe 15 seconds to completely take all the debris out, and it was back to new, just like that. Then you close it, lock it in position, just like that, and you're ready for another use. It does contain quite a bit. But of course, if you've got more debris, you need to you know, empty it more often just to make sure that the machine and the vacuum works at its optimal condition. And the other thing I'm a super big fan of is that when you're done using it, you need to store it somewhere and charge it, of course. Well, this is where this base station, charging station is. It's made of plastic, it's super light, as you can see, and literally stands right there. You will connect these prongs all the way to these two prongs right here. Got a little spring. And boom, that is it. That is all. Right now, it's charging. They do provide you with the charging cable as well. Plug that in the wall. You can keep this in the shed. You can keep this in your pool room. You can keep this really anywhere. Looks really, really nice, and it's always ready to go whenever you need to clean your pool. Oh, and for those wondering about the power mode and the battery life, if you're on normal mode, I said it before, it's 70 minutes of basically cleaning time. I don't think you're gonna need 70 minutes to clean a pool, especially with this vacuum because it is so good. But the Hyperblast, the super turbo mode, gives you 45 minutes. In my opinion, I would stick to the turbo mode, make that vacuum cleaning of your pool a breeze, super, super fast. And yeah, I love the way it looks. AIPER makes incredible pool products. This is no exception. It is a fantastic, fantastic little vacuum. Make sure to submerge it though, or else it will not work properly. A lot of people have had that problem where like, oh, well, the steps are not working. You need to submerge it underwater all the way here, all the way to past the logo, and you're good to go. AIPER, we love it.